Right, just a quick video on the BF Falcon Ute fuses and fuse box. Here's a printout layout of all the fuses. So I'm just going to go over them first so you can have a good look at that. And obviously it gives you the fuse, the amperage, the colour, classification or circuit protected, and the type. So they are starting from one. I'm just going to go through them slowly so you can pick out which one you're looking for. And then up here, continuation, 21, 22, etc. And then you have your big block fuses there, one for ignition. This is the R1, R2, R3, R4. Accessory tail lights, power windows, etc. So we're going to look at them. Now this is the main diagram of what you'll see. It's actually shaped like that. The book's got it the other way. But that's what you'll see when you open the panel. And I'll explain some of those. And this is your guide of all the ones you just read previously to what they do. So we'll go ahead and open the panel. Right, the panel is located in the driver's side, just below the ignition on the right hand side, or the left of the door on the driver's side. And as you can see, there's a hand opening there to pull it down, so you just reach in there and pull it down towards the floor. It's very easily undone because it's just clipped in. And there's our fuses. Okay, just so you know how they number, number one is here, so 1 to 15, 1 to 15, 16 across to 30. That's how they number all the fuses. Now these are the big main ones, the R1, 2, 3 and 4, etc. These ones here are for power windows, and that's the front and that's the back. This being a ute, there's no back power windows, that's why there's a hole there. And this is for the power seat, and these are all for your different devices in the car, and you just got to look up the number. Ford actually thought a little bit better about this than some of their previous designs I've seen. This is your scan tool plug. You just plug your scan tool. It only can clip one way. It's shaped in a V. You only can put it on one way, so that's where that is. If you've got a scan tool, just plug in there. And you'll turn the ignition for it to actually read. Now, believe it or not, if you're out in the road and you needed one of these, it's gone or something, Ford actually supply spares, and this is your spares right here. So you have 6 spares of all the different, one of each amperage and colour code to these. So, and if you got no tool, they even supply that. There's a little tool here, you just pull that out, and it's shaped to go on the edge of the fuses, and you just pull them out. So that just sits above the spares up in there, and away you go. So that's really good by Ford to supply spares and a little tool to use to replace any of these that have open circuit or gone open circuit so they don't work anymore. So there's some little tips there. Now to test them, all you need is a test lamp, about $10 from your auto shop, and so easy to use. You just earth it, and it's just going to use the onboard power that's already there. So I'm just going to earth it to the door. There's a little bolt here on the door that I can earth it to, because we obviously only got so much wire, and that's nice and handy. So I'll just earth that to that bolt on the door. Now, just to show you how it works, we'll pick any fuse So this green one looks the go. See that? If we can get that in shot, move it back. Now these fuses have little test points, as you can see. I'm just putting that on and off. You got to test both sides, so I move to the other side, and that shows that the circuits goes right across. There we go, good light. And the other side, good light. So that one's working perfectly. Some of these fuses you might need to turn the ignition on to test them, they don't work. You know, like parking lights, whichever one, you might have to turn your parking light on to see it, and then test it, things like that. But if you get light on one side, it's light on one side, but if I put it the other side, I'm getting light on the other. But if I didn't, that's a faulty one. So I can take that green one out of the spare and put it in here and get going again. So that's just a general little display of how to test them using a test lamp. Quite easy. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.